Unscripted.
Man, stop the presses. PlayStation 5 is dead. Microsoft is killing it. Xbox Series X, Xbox Series S all the way. Phil Spencer, the man is doing amazing work. He has come down from on high almost to do some of the best work we've ever seen. I mean, honestly, have we ever seen such an amazing display of just craftsmanship, ownership? Phil Spencer is absolutely crushing Sony with his bare hands right now. And honestly, should we all be surprised that this is the case? Just look at the media. Everybody is joining Xbox, Team Xbox over here. IGN, Team Xbox. We've got Jeff Grubb, Team Xbox. We've got everybody out there, Team Xbox. They're all abandoning PlayStation. PlayStation Nation can't win. We're all questioning what's going on with PlayStation. How can PlayStation possibly win? How can they ever do anything, right? What can PlayStation do? How can they ever fight back? Will they ever be relevant again? How can this happen to them? Well, you know, guess what? PlayStation is perfectly fine. Honestly, PlayStation 100% perfectly 100% fine. Why are they fine? Well, they're fine because guess what? They're out there breaking records. How fast we forget. Now let's rack this up here for a second. How fast are people to forget about how good PlayStation is actually selling, how well they're doing? Okay, let's take, for example, Miles Morales, the game that Xbox fanboys called DLC. Well, DLC isn't sold on the NPD like that. Yet this quote-unquote DLC has now outsold Ghost of Tsushima as well as The Last of Us Part 2, and is still in the top 5 on the NPD. How is it that this game has such exponential legs, right? How is it that PlayStation keeps selling so well? Haven't they heard the news? Haven't they heard the news that Phil Spencer is an amazing leader? Haven't they heard the news that Game Pass is a thing? Look, you can get games for $15 a month, $180 a year. Haven't these people heard that? Why are they still buying PlayStations in record numbers? It doesn't make any sense. It's almost like the average person doesn't live in an echo chamber on social media. How could this be? How? I would love to know. We have this to think about. PS5, fastest seller in U.S. history in both units and dollars, according to NPD. The NPD Group has released their full North American sales data for March 2021, and the year continues to be lucrative for the industry. Players spent a record $5.6 billion on games, additional content, and hardware in March, up 18% compared to the same period last year. The Nintendo Switch was the top-selling system again, but the PlayStation 5 is off to a very good start. It's the fastest-selling console in U.S. history over its first 5 months, both in terms of unit and dollar sales. Considering the PS5 is still heavily supply constrained, expect more records to be smashed in the future. Think about that. The PlayStation 5 is absolutely crushing the Xbox right now. Xbox is in last place. Last place. They're not the market leader. They're not what Colt Eastwood says. They aren't the market leader, folks. They aren't anywhere close to the market leader. Have you ever noticed that the people that say things like console sales and game sales don't matter are only Xbox fans? Why is that? Why is it that only Xbox fans are the ones saying this type of stuff? It couldn't be because Xbox is in last place, doing the least. I'm not saying they're not doing anything in terms of money-wise, right? Like, let's just be clear, okay? You have McDonald's, you have Burger King, you have Wendy's, okay? Wendy's is behind both McDonald's and Burger King, but Wendy's is still making bank. You know, look, Microsoft is still making bank. But you're not going to hear people who eat at Wendy's go, you know, the people that work for Wendy's and Wendy's themselves, the corporation, go, you know, I think it's foolish to count sales and money that we make. Let's count some other metric that we actually do, chicken nuggets sold or something. You know what I mean? Like, you can't change the metrics just because you're getting your butt kicked. That's not the way these things work. You know, that's not the way these things have ever worked. So, again, I think somebody forgot to tell Sony that they should be losing right now. right? They should honestly be losing. Because according to, you know, all the pundits and, you know, all this kind of stuff, they're getting their butts kicked. Listen, IGN was in a fervor. They said that, you know, Sony's not going to take any risks anymore. I mean, that's what they said. Sony not taking risks. They're not going to take any more risks in the future because, guess what? Yeah, it doesn't seem like they're going to be wanting to do those double A's anytime soon. They're totally focused on triple A's. But guess what? Even Jason Schreier has retracted that now. He said he didn't mean that they would only work on double A's or they wouldn't take risks or anything. But those of us that had the common freaking sense to actually look into things, we already knew this. We already knew this. All right? Because why? Because if Sony weren't taking risks, why would they be doing PlayStation VR 2? Why would they be doing more Astrobot? Why would they be doing Returnal? Why would they be letting Ben do a new IP? You know? Why would they let the London studio be doing a new IP? Why would they be doing doubling down on Dreams developer Media Molecule? Why would they do any of this stuff if it were in fact true that they were not taking risks anymore? It just doesn't make any sense when you look at the evidence. And so I'm glad that Jason Schreier came out and actually said the truth, the honest truth, and nothing but the truth, folks, when it comes to PlayStation. A lot of people were running for the hills. Uh-oh, time to trade in your PlayStation 5. Let's go get us an Xbox, despite the fact that Xbox hasn't put out a AAA exclusive in almost 600 days. Yeah, let's go with them. Let's get them, because let's all line up to play our old games better, okay? You know what? Things just don't work that way. You know, again, there's an echo chamber that is social media. We all know this. They aren't the be-all, end-all when it comes to what happens in video games, right? They aren't. They really aren't. Video games are always going to be something that is going to draw comparisons and where people are going to butt heads because we all have something to lose. We all have something to gain. We want that competition to be there. But again, you can't force it. If Microsoft were truly the market leader, what the hell market are they leading? If things were backwards, yeah. You know, if the last was first, if first was last, but this isn't that. You know, if you wanted to say something along the lines of Microsoft and Xbox was the market leader in services, you know, that offer game rentals, then absolutely, they're doing a much better market job than, you know, Sony or Nintendo. But again, if you're just even comparing services, PlayStation Plus has 50 million subscribers almost. You know, compared to 18 million for Game Pass. And we don't know how many subscribers Nintendo has on Nintendo Network, but it could be 20 million or more. If you want to play online with Nintendo, you have to have Nintendo services. So again, we don't really know what's going on. You know, we don't. And, you know, at the end of the day, I think that that people kind of forget that. You know, we're all kind of wrapped up in our own things and, you know, think one thing over the other. But still, think about that. Everybody was saying it was the end of Xbox or it was the end of PlayStation and Xbox had won. And, you know, even people like Colin Moriarty, who I respect the hell out of, you know, we all thought that they were, you know, putting out the pasture or whatever. You know, honestly, we all thought that. And to be honest with you, like now we see these outlets kind of stepping back a little bit and going, well, maybe our thing wasn't exactly accurate. You know, Jeff Grubb redid his article. You had Schreier try to kind of update what he was meaning instead of, you know, instead of what everybody was taking it for. You know, the PS5 is dominating right now, you know. Again, that's not saying the Series X couldn't do something its own, but it doesn't even look like Xbox Series X is outpacing the Xbox One at this point. So where are we going to take this from? Where is this all going to lead? What does it mean? It means that gaming is fine. It means that gaming is good, but PlayStation is obviously was always going to be the better bet to win and the better bet to sell more and the better bet to make more revenue and profit because they make games and they make really great games and they're doubling down on making those great games. That's not a bad thing. And they're not stopping to make the other stuff in the meantime either. That's just something that, you know, was kind of invented. Yes, they're going to focus on AAA, but to say that they wouldn't do anything otherwise is absolutely ignorance on anybody's part. So, with that being said, yes, congratulations to Sony on breaking records, your own records, mind you. Microsoft isn't even in the top three or four in this aspect right now. You know, imagine if people who really wanted a PlayStation 5 could get one without having to go through a scalper. I think, man, what a fantastic time it is to be a gamer. Congrats, Sony. This is Crap Gamer. This has been Crap Gamer Reviews. Thank you so much for watching. Rack 'em up. Crap Gamer, out. Unscripted.